that he created for us. He has a place. He's got a place for you on the ranch. He told us when he left that I'm going to prepare a place for you. You know, that just came to my mind as I said that, as I recited that scripture. I'm going to prepare a place for you. We've always interpreted that as he's going to prepare a place for me in heaven. What about the place he prepared for me right here?
Amen.
He's prepared a place for me right here to walk in. He's prepared a path for me to walk in right here that I can walk in the truth and the peace and the comfort of knowing that I don't have to worry about tribulation. I don't have to worry about trouble. He's going to walk me right through the middle of it, because what is he doing through my obedience? He's edifying what? The church. He's building it up. He's making it stronger. He's revealing to us as we go day by day how big this thing really is. You think Joel Osteen's got a big church? It ain't nothing compared to the church of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God's church is huge. It's way beyond that. So much bigger, and you're part of it. You know, people sit and they go, wow, I wonder what it's like to belong to a church that big. My church is 10 times that big. The church I belong to covers the entire globe. It has services all over. You know when they show Santa Claus on Christmas Day, and they're showing Christmas Eve, and they're showing Santa Claus here and there, and they got, by the end of the night on the news, they got all these red dots. There's 10 churches for everyone in red dots.
Amen.
And that's God. That's God's church. That's the church that we belong to. Where's your church at? Well, I don't know. What town are you in? Well, I'm in Casa Grande. Well, there's 57 churches in Casa Grande. Take a pick. Because if you're serving the Lord, he'll put you where he is. He'll bring you to his presence. He'll bring you right where he's at so that he can minister to you, so he can edify you, so he can lift you up and say, now go, just like he did the apostle. Now go tell somebody. Just like Pablo. Martha says, Pablo cannot wait to get here and share his testimony. He's just chomping at the bit. He's just, I got to do that. Because he knows each time he shares his testimony, it's going to touch somebody. Sharing that the events that happened in his life through what God did in his life is going to touch somebody. And he's going to be teaching somebody. He's going to be pastoring somebody. He's going to be evangelizing somebody. And he's going to be an apostle. Simply by sharing his testimony, saying, this is what Jesus Christ did in my life. He's teaching, he's preaching, he's prophesying, he's being an apostle, he's an evangelist, all in that. And we say, we read that scripture and we think, well, there's a group of people that do that. Yeah, there is. And it's the ones that have accepted Jesus Christ as their Savior. That's the group of people that do that. Just like the 12 apostles. We read about the 12 apostles. These are the ones that God, Jesus collected to do that. That's right. And he selected you to be part of that group. He started a little old bitty ranch a long time ago. And now it's huge. When I worked for John Malone, 356 square miles of ranch. All contiguous. They're all connected. You could ride. A little joke. I'll just go off for a minute here. These two guys are talking at the cafe, at the coffee shop one morning. One guy said, my ranch is so big. He said, I can drive my pickup all day long and not get all the way across my ranch. The other guy goes, yeah, I got a pickup just like that. But that ranch was that big. You could drive all day and you'd have a hard time getting all the way across. But the church of Jesus Christ is all these people that he brings them in. I've just been amazed. I've been just been amazed in the last year how God has brought people in, and we get to meet them, and we get to know them, and our spirits mingle together, and we realize we got brothers and sisters, and then God sends them on out. That we realize how big this thing is that God is doing. It's not just here in Arizona City. It's not just here in Pinal County. It's not just here in Arizona. It's all over the world God is doing this. And you get to be part of that. So let the joy of knowing that I'm part of this edification, I'm part of the plan that Jesus Christ has to build his church, and I'm right in the middle of it. We're right in the middle of Brandon Day. We're right in the middle of everything's going on. When you get an opportunity to share the gospel, share it. If somebody asks you something, or somebody, you see, you know, I'll share this, I've shared it before. But many years ago, I was walking into Home Depot. And as I walked past the paint counter, there was a guy on his knees behind the counter. And he was just weeping. He was weeping hard. And I felt in my spirit, this guy needs prayer. He needs help. And I was so busy, I just walked on. And I don't guess I'll ever forget that day, because that was a perfect opportunity for me to take 30 seconds out of my life. 30 seconds that I could have given to Jesus Christ and could have helped that guy just by praying with him. There's always somebody we'll run into that needs prayer. You'll see him. God will reveal them to you. God will show them to you. God will point them out. That person over there, you need to go pray with them. Oh, I don't know who that is. He didn't ask you if you, he said, you know, he didn't say, do you know who that is? He said, no. He said, see that person over there, you need to go pray with him. You need to go share the gospel with him. Maybe you're at the checkout at Walmart and the Lord puts it on your heart that you need to share the gospel with this checker. She looks like she's pretty upset. And so many times I've asked people, they're just, God bless you. Oh, thank you, I needed that. Three little words. Not hard. Very simple, very easy. God bless you. Oh, thank you, I needed that. I needed it too. Because I needed to be obedient to what God was calling me to do. Because as much a blessing as they received, I got it right back. Thank you, Lord. And sometimes it takes more than that. But God has already prepared that path. Your niche is following God. Your niche is doing what God would have you to do. Your peace and your comfort in this life is only going to be found when you find your niche. Your peace and your comfort on a ranch is only going to be there when you find the place that you fit in. Some guys, we had a guy, Mike, that could, you could put him out in the pasture and he could go gather pasture all by himself. He didn't need any help. He didn't even want any help. Put me out there, leave me alone, I'll gather, I'll bring him the corn. He knew how to do it, he knew what he's doing, he'd done it enough. If he needed help, he wasn't afraid to ask for help. But he had learned how to do it, and just from doing it, and that's what God does in your life. And the more you'll do that, the more you'll learn how to do it. To where you recognize the opportunity, you'll jump right in, you'll say, you know what, I need to tell you something about Jesus. Have you ever asked anybody, have you got your wedding invitation yet? There's all kinds of neat little things you can ask somebody. You get your wedding? What wedding? The marriage of the Lamb. Did you get your inheritance? Did you know you have an inheritance? Well, I ain't got no inheritance. Yeah, you do. I promise you, you do. All you got to do is ask for it. It doesn't cost anything. It doesn't even have to be written down on paper because it already is. And it's permanent. It's in permanent ink. And the word, that inheritance is written down many, 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 many thousand years ago. And if you'll receive it, if you'll accept it, you're going to have it. But you have to say, God, I want my inheritance. I want to do what I have to do to get in the family of God so that I have an inheritance. So I'm a joint heir with Jesus Christ. A joint heir with Jesus Christ. I'm going to read on now. We're going to finish up Ephesians 4. I'm going to read 16 and 17. Now, this is where we read about he gave teachers and preachers and apostles and evangelists. Now, from verse 16, from whom the whole body, fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, making increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. This I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as the Gentiles walk in the vanity of their mind. He says, through being an apostle, through being an evangelist, through being a teacher, through being a preacher, through doing those things, we all fit together real nice and tight. And every joint that's working, every part that's working, everybody that's doing their part, it brings us to the edifying of ourselves. It builds up the church all by itself, just by everybody doing their part. When you're standing there at the corrals, a little before daylight, and you hear the cowboys bringing the cattle up for branding day, and it's too dark to see them yet, but you can hear them. Sounds like a lot of cows. When the sun begins to break open and they're just about there, you're like, that is a lot of cows. It's a whole lot bigger than it sounds. And I'll never forget the first time, I'm like, wow, I wonder how many days this is going to take. We was done by lunchtime. We was done in time to go to lunch. That was the amazing thing about the ranch. We'd work hard, we started daylight, and at lunchtime we had lunch, and after that you just went and got in your pickup and went and checked on your cows. Pretty much the rest of the day, just go make sure your cows got minerals and they got water and they got salt. Make sure the fences are up. You don't even have to get out of the pickup. where we come to the place and say, Lord, I'm going to do whatever you need me to do today. I'm going to get up early in the morning. David tells us that in the Psalms. Early in the morning am I going to seek you, Lord. I'm going to get up early in the morning. I'm going to go find what you got for me to do because I need to get my job on this ranch done. I need to do my part this morning. And by lunchtime, he's going to say, come on in for dinner. Now just go home. Take it easy the rest of the day. Thank you for being on the spot. Thank you for being part of what we're doing. Thank you for listening to the voice that says, that called me out and tells me I am an apostle, I am a preacher, I am a prophet, I am an evangelist, I am all those things because I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can share the gospel with the orneriest, meanest, craziest guy you ever met and not have to be afraid. I can walk through anything. I can do, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. Psalms 23. David knew what it was like to say, I'm going to get up early in the morning, Lord. I'm going to come find you. I'm not going to wait for you to wake me up and tell me to get my lazy bum out of bed. I'm going to be standing at the gate waiting. I'm going to be saddled up. Old Marvin, the guy on the ranch, I always thought Marvin was crazy. Because he would be at the saddle barn and have everybody's horse saddled before anybody else even got up. I'm like, man, this guy's nuts. But he did his part. That's what he felt like he was supposed to do. And in that, he was serving everybody. He did a service to everybody. You could just walk down there and your horse standing ready to go. Pull up the cinch, bail on and go. Now, you wanted to make sure that you was kind of a close friend with Marvin. Because he was picking the horse you were going to ride today. It could be a pretty rough day if you had aggravated Marvin a little bit the week before. But nonetheless, we all went, we all worked hard, and we all got it all done. And it's the same way in the body of Christ. We all get up in the morning, we seek the Lord, we go do what he has for us to do, and he brings us that joy and that peace. A peace that we just can't even understand. The world can't offer it. The world don't have it. We're looking for that niche that's going to bring me some joy and some happiness. Well, I can tell you exactly where it's at. Waking up in the morning to get on your knees, we're going to find your niche.
Amen.
You're going to find right where you belong.
Amen.
Right where God wants you to be. One more scripture. I'm going to close. Say in Ephesians, go to 3:8-12. Ephesians 3:8-12. Unto me, who am less than the least of all saints. Paul said, unto me, the one that is the least of all saints, and this grace given, that I should preach among the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ, and to make all men see what is the fellowship of the mystery, from which the beginning of the world hath been hid in God, who created all things by Jesus Christ, to the intent that now unto the principalities and the powers in heavenly places might be known by the church the manifold wisdom of God, according to the eternal purpose which he purposed in Christ Jesus our Lord, in what? In whom we have boldness and access with confidence by faith of him.
Amen.
What else can you say? Paul is using every big word in his vocabulary. Paul is driving, hitting the, he's standing there with a gavel and he's beating on the thing. He's saying, you guys got to get this. Do you realize what you have? Do you realize what you're part of? Do you realize what's available to you? Do you realize the blessing that you get by using it? Do you realize the peace that you're going to have in your life? When you say, you know what, I'm going to get this morning. I'm going to get on my knees. I'm going to find the Lord and I'm going to follow him around for a little while. If you ever call work and say, I'm going to be late. I'm walking around with Jesus right now. I'll be about an hour late. Maybe two, you know. But he's got something he wants me to do this morning. And I want to be sure and do that because the payday that he has, the inheritance that I have through him, is far more than you can pay me. He has a niche in life that you fit right into. He created, as Paul said, way before the beginning of the world. If through Christ Jesus, he created all things. And for him and by him were all things created. There was not anything created that wasn't created by him. So learn to walk in that peace. Learn to walk in that joy that, you know what, God is really doing this. This is really his church, and I really belong to it. We've got to get our mind wrapped around how big this thing is. It's not just a little church here in Arizona City. This is just one little fingerprint on a whole big thing. Let's make our fingerprint. It's kind of scary when the guy told me that in the circles he's been in, my name always comes up. And I thought, that should be a good thing. because this guy goes to church and the church and the church and the church. Now maybe they tell them, maybe my name comes up, that guy out there in Arizona City is plumb crazy. Well, they thought Isaiah was crazy. They thought Jeremiah was crazy. If I'm crazy about the Lord, that's okay. You can paint that on my forehead. That's okay. That's okay. They're not talking about me, they're talking about this church. They're talking about this body of people that come together. This little big town in Arizona got this little church, this cowboy church down there. And they have a church all the time. Every time you go by, there's somebody there. I don't know what they do there all the time. They fly their flags, the Christian flag above. They do all this crazy stuff. They do the Feast of Tabernacles, for Pete's sakes. They're crazy. Well, we better go down there and see what they're doing. Come on, huh? Come on, we'll show you what we're doing. We're praising the Lord, amen? We're going to lift up His name. We're going to sing praise. We're just going to give it all to Him. When we get company, we're going to have a family reunion. Somebody comes from out of town, good, let's have a potluck. Let's do all kinds of fun things. Let's really let God know I love you, Lord. And I love everything you do. And when you bring people to my home, you bring people to your place, to the place where we worship you, you bring people to us so that we can be filled. That's what He said. The apostles and the evangelists, He sends them out to edify, to build up. And that's what happens when we come together and these people come. And Billy and Louise, they come and they're with us for a little while. And we learn to love them. And they say, okay, now God's sending us off. We never wanted to be in the ministry, but now God's sending us off because through the fellowship of one another, we've edified and built up, and God said, okay, I got you in the spot. I'm going to use you now. Put me in, coach. I want to be the one. I want to be the first one up. I want to be the one at the saddle shed before anybody else, and I want to get all the saddles on all the horses. Let me be that one to just give you my all in everything that I do, Lord. Let me pray and give you thanks, regardless of what's going on, regardless of what I see. I don't want to see with my eyes anymore. I want to see with my heart. I want to see with my spirit. I want to see what God is doing, and the only way I can do that is close my eyes and get on my knees. And then I can see clearly what God is doing. Somebody asked me one time, how come you always close your eyes when you sing it? Because I'm looking for Jesus. And I know He's right there in that song I'm singing. And if I got my eyes closed, I'm just focused on Him. I ain't focused on nothing else. I'm focused on what He's doing and what He has to say for me. When I hear all you guys singing, I just feel like saying, listen, Jesus, they're singing to you. They love you, Jesus. They're singing to you. They love you, Lord. It's amazing. It's amazing. We're going to do a couple of songs and we're going to pray. You can do, and it's very simple, and it's very clear, and it's very plain. And we look all around it. We don't ever. Sometimes it takes us a little while to look at it, because to look at it and see, we got to close our eyes. We got to say, you know what? It's all world blows. And sometimes it seems like a damn dark, dim place. But when I walk in the light of the Lord, where else could I go? Where else would I want to be? What else would I want to be doing? Yeah, I want to go to heaven someday, but I want to get all the horses saddled first. I want to get everything done as far as get done before it's time to go. Get my chores done. My wife's gonna give me. I could never eat till I'd already fed the animals. That was just a rule at the house. You don't get to eat till your dogs and your horse and your pigs. And we had 40 pigs and chicken. I had to get up real early. If I wanted hot biscuits because they get cold by the time I get back to the house, if I didn't hurry up and get my chores done. So hurry up and get your chores done. Amen. Where else could we go? Thank you.